morning all. It's a beautiful Sunday autumn morning. It's about 12 degrees today and a lovely sunshine. So I have a little ride, got my son on the back. Just going out to Ditchling Beacon. Stuff to do this afternoon, so it can't be too long. But just a little ride out. And it's been a year, just a little more than a year, since I've been back on the bike riding again. So what do I think of it? Well, let's go through some things that I've done. So, the Honda VFR 1200F. Got it a year ago, just over a year ago. And all in all, it's a very good bike. As you expect from the 1200, loads of power, loads of bottom end torque. It'll pull virtually in any gear, as you'd expect. And for me, it's comfy. So is it a sports bike, is it a tourer? Well, I think I'll agree with what most people say. It's neither one nor the other, and somewhere in between, depending on what upgrades you would do to it, in my humble opinion. So for instance, to make it a tourer, you'd really want to put a bigger screen on, which is what I've done. If you wanted to make it a more sports bike, then you'd probably want to mess with the ECU and have it reflashed. So you've got all the power in all the gears and not the standard Honda. Only gives you 60% in first and second and I think third. Having said that, of course, it's still powerful enough as it is. So what else have I done to this? So radiator guard, front fender extender, rear hugger. That's the main things I've done. Put some power sockets on here, because you don't get anything like that with Honda. Put a Kyoko throttle control on here, because you don't get anything like cruise control with Honda. So for Honda to make this a GT or a Tourer, there's a heck of a lot they would really need to do to it. Or to its successor, which who knows when that will be or what it will be. Riding wise, probably more in the sports area than it is the tour area. So tour, you probably want to sit a little bit further upright, handlebars a little bit, you know, maybe an inch too further back, maybe an inch too higher. Which you can do, you can buy, I think they're called helibars. But again, you know, it's extra expense. It's like 300 quid or something silly to have that done. But, you know, if you plan to keep the bike and you like it that much and you do all lots of touring, then, you know, it'd be worth doing. Saddle, it's comfy enough for rides out. I've done, you know, 150, 160 miles on it and I don't have any problem. But again, you know, you can spend upwards to 200 to, you know, I've seen £600 on an upgraded saddle, you know, heat in it, gel in it. So there is all sorts you can do. It just depends really on how much you want to spend on it. Where you say the exhaust is horrible, doesn't have any sound to it, well, you know, that's personal preference. Yes, if I had the extra cash, yes, I'd probably buy another one. For aesthetics purposes and a bit more sound, but you know, it is what it is. Personally, I love this bike. It's got everything that I want with it. It'll keep up with anything if you wanted it to, if you're a good enough rider, which I will admit I am not. I'm not one of these people that's been riding bikes all my life. I've done what quite a lot of other people have done. Rode when you're a teenager, kept the boat for a little bit while, going to cars because they were much warmer in the winter. Me specifically, I didn't even bother to get the license at that time when I should have done. And we did the license about a year and a half ago, or did the license a year and a half ago. And here I am, 30 years later, back on the bikes again. Which I have to say, thoroughly enjoying. But I'm a bit of a fair weather rider. see from the footage, we've got the camera mounted now just under the headlamp to give some nice flat footage of the roads and the riding. So although the head cam is good, obviously you've got head movement on it, which can be horrible when you're watching a vid. This is a very nice pub just here on our left. Gardener's Arms, it's called. If you're in this sort of area, southern area, come and visit it, it's beautiful. Great food. I was lucky enough with this bike when I found it that I got all the panniers, top box, heated grips were already on it, the wind deflectors here on the side were already on it, the original OEM screen had the touring deflector screen on it. So the person that bought it brand new, and this was I bought it with only one owner previous, had all the extras paid put on there, and I mean, you know, it's not cheap. Heated grips, you know, 260-70 quid, I think it were. Wind deflectors, 150 quid. You know, the OEM screen wind deflector, another 150 quid. Honda, you're really expensive. You know, and to buy the bike back then, new, wasn't cheap either, and it came with hardly anything. If you wanted all that stuff, you got to pay the extra for it. So I was quite lucky enough to get everything on there that I needed. And so then me and my friends finally decided to get our backsides into gear and sort something out, weekends away or whatever, a little week, 3 or 4 day touring thing, Friday over a Monday. Then I've got the gear ready, and it's all just clip-on stuff, so it's fantastic and lockable, all with a single key. Sunday cyclists. And it is, oh come on love. Really? We'll be right back.
Mother?